In the wild mountains around Yellowstone, elk are on the move. And trail cameras can give us new insights into how animals migrate. I'm Travis Zaffarano, and I'm a wildlife biologist from Cody, Wyoming. I spent years hiking backcountry elk trails for my graduate research at the University of Wyoming. My study showed that trail cameras give an up-close view of elk migrations that is sometimes missing from GPS collar data. The cameras give a very accurate count of elk herds and reveal how bulls and cows migrate differently. Trail cameras are also cheaper and safer than doing aerial surveys. This could be the cutting edge of migration research, and the images are fascinating in their own right. As I wrapped up my research, I wanted to try to capture elk in video. In 2018, we set out to tell the story of one elk corridor over the entire fall migration season. This is the story of what we found, and what these trail cameras can show us about migration. Over a period of 2 months, I set up trail cameras with Greg Nickerson of the Wyoming Migration Initiative. We were assisted by Wyoming Game and Fish biologist Greg Anderson and several volunteers. Our team drove, hiked, and skied for about 100 hours to give the public a glimpse into these incredible migrations. The elk and other wildlife put on an amazing show. We recorded hundreds of elk and deer migrating out of the mountains, along with grizzlies and wolves. This is just one corridor out of dozens in western Wyoming. Movement is life for these wild animals. Filming this elk migration corridor near Yellowstone was a dream project. I grew up in a family of elkaholics, where elk were a year-round obsession. Like me, Greg is a lifelong elk hunter who grew up in Bighorn, Wyoming. We both hoped we'd be able to capture the spectacle of elk migration that we grew up with. We were really fortunate that it snowed the week after we set up the cameras, and that caused the elk to start migrating. We observed some large herds right off the bat. This herd of about 50 elk making their fall migration was one of the largest groups we filmed during daytime. You can see a mix of cows, spikes, and a few large bulls. Usually 90% of cows give birth to calves in any given year. But only some of those calves survive their first summer. Those that don't make it usually die from poor nutrition, accidents, disease, drought, or predation. The way the herd moves is really interesting. They seem to be moving slowly, taking their time. Some of the elk are on alert, others are grazing, some are even sparring. And then there is a big bull keeping everyone in line. At the end of the herd were always a few animals that didn't look quite as fit as the others. The elk seemed to bunch up whenever they entered the trees. But then they spread out to graze when they hit the open meadows, because the meadows allow them to stop over and refuel for the rest of the day. Deer and elk only spend a small portion of their migration season on the move. The majority of the time, they are grazing in stopovers. This herd is halfway through its migration corridor. They move about 70 miles from high elevation areas in Yellowstone National Park to lower deserts where they spend the winter months. But as we would find out, these elk aren't the only species migrating along this corridor. Just like elk, these migrating mule deer spend summer in the high country around Yellowstone National Park. As winter approaches, they migrate to escape the snow. Of all the big game species, pronghorn are the first to migrate in the fall. That's because their small hooves cause them to sink into the snow. Like pronghorn, mule deer also have small hooves and short legs, so they're usually the next to migrate. Most elk migrate a few weeks later than mule deer. They can move pretty well in moderately deep snow. Moose, however, have long legs and big hooves that act like snowshoes, helping them move through the snow, so they are usually the last to migrate out of the high country in fall. Our cameras didn't observe any pronghorn or moose on this trail, but we can see that an intact migration corridor gives multiple species the connectivity to move between far-flung seasonal ranges.
Setting up cameras on an elk migration corridor gave us a glimpse into the daily life of a migrating elk herd. Sometimes the cameras capture things you don't expect. Like my buddy Travis hamming it up while we were testing out cameras on campus. Just like we have personalities, so do the elk. One of the interesting things that stood out in the footage was the series of elk we collectively nicknamed Spike. These were all juvenile male elk, about a year or two old. Spike has survived his first summer and winter as a calf. This is his second year of life and his third migration. He's gone through puberty and has his first set of antlers, and he's acting like a teenager, pushing his buddies around. He's curious, bullheaded, a little naive, and he's constantly testing the limits of his strength with other spikes. He's seen where he fits into the pecking order. As Spike matures into a bull elk, this is the kind of assertiveness that eventually may reward him with control of his own harem of females and his own reproductive success. Altogether, the camera's got about 8 minutes of raw footage of spikes. This gives us a view into the daily life of juvenile elk in a large herd on one of the many migration corridors of the greater Yellowstone ecosystem. When we set out camera traps on an elk migration trail, we knew the area is also home for grizzly bears. That's part of what makes the greater Yellowstone ecosystem such a wild place. And so, we took all of the precautions for grizzly bear safety when doing our field work. That meant carrying pepper spray and training how to use it. Just as important, hey, we always traveled in a group and made lots of noise.
Howdy, bear.
And those are grizzly tracks. Right there.
We never saw any bears in person, but our trail cameras captured quite a few grizzlies along the elk trail. One grizzly seemed to go past the camera every few days. Here's the bear going up the trail, and here's the bear coming back the other way. Late fall is when bears are in hyperphagia, eating as many calories as possible so they can hibernate through the winter. You can just see the massive power of this bear. You can tell it's been eating well. Grizzlies like to prey on elk calves at the very end of the spring migration. By fall, migrating elk calves can run faster than grizzly bears, so they've escaped bear predation for now. Wolves also traveled the elk migration trail, though the pack mostly showed up near the end of the fall season. Grizzlies and wolves aren't the only predators on the trail. This tough little coyote was the last critter to come through before we took down our cameras in December.
How do elk know when to migrate, where to go, and how to get there? How do they maximize their chances of survival? Our cameras gave us some clues into their strategy. They tell a story of migration beginning in October, peaking in November, and trailing off into December. So what's going on that made this big pulse of migration happen? If we look back to the days when most elk were moving, we can see a huge storm rolled through. As snow piles up in the high country, the grass gets buried and the food becomes scarce. So the elk know they must get to lower ground where there is less snow. The storm kicked off the major wave of migration. Hundreds of elk came through. It was almost continuous traffic for 3 days. Big bulls migrate first, breaking the trail, while the rest move in groups following a few experienced leaders. Usually it's the lead cow that determines it's time to go. The elk calves, having never migrated before, are learning their routes from their mothers. The timing of migration is crucial. Some elk don't time it right and they struggle through in December, spending more energy and burning off their fat reserves. That's a danger because they may not have enough fat left to survive the winter, or successfully carry their pregnancies to full term. So for elk, knowing the best time to migrate and the right routes to travel when the weather turns can be a matter of life or death. In 4 years of trekking and monitoring trail cameras, I gathered a mountain of data that will help plan future management of migratory elk herds. But for me, it's become so much more than that. Beyond the graphs and research reports, these images bring migration to life. I gained a lot of respect for these animals, having hiked these routes and seen the mountain passes they go over. I can really see what the elk are going through during these migrations and how well adapted they are to endure. I see the harshness of winter and the resurgence of spring.
This is where it all begins.
Just a bunch of elk tracks coming through, all headed in the direction of the summer range.
They are very perceptive animals, and they know so much. They know how to work together as a unit to sustain the herd and how to care for their young. I see them growing up, learning the migration corridor, and passing it down to the next generation. I see them interacting and having fun. I see the strongest ones blazing trail and the weakest struggling behind. I see how the elk provide food for predators, including hunters like myself. I've come to understand that elk migration is more than just survival of individuals. Ultimately, these movements are what it takes for herds to remain abundant. Not only are these images a tool for biologists, they also tell the story of the elk and the incredible things they do to make it every year. So many elk make these amazing journeys because migration is the best way to thrive in this rugged country of Wyoming.